Hi and welcome to another video for linmob.net. Today, as you can see by this image, I'm showing you Arch Linux ARM on the PinePhone, and I'm going to try to install Nbox on it, and we'll show you how to get a keyboard and maybe more. Now, why am I saying maybe? Well, this is the fourth attempt, I guess, at recording this video, and I had a ton of problems earlier, so I don't want to overpromise. Well, okay, I've been a little too quick here, starting the terminal already. The first run with that will come up shortly, I'm sure. Well, that's what I hope. Well, can just try to connect to Wi-Fi in other ways. And there is my Wi-Fi network. So, yeah. There it is. Yeah, see, if I would be a little more patient. But, yeah. So, let's start using Arch Linux ARM. Now, I will have to upgrade the distribution, and because Arch has a package manager that saves you a lot of typing, it's just sudo pacman dash uppercase s y u, and when I type some packages after that, they will be installed in the same process. So let's just install nbox dash image and adb. Now, ADB will be helpful to install apps into Nbox that aren't in the FDroid App Store that comes pre-installed with this image. Now, it failed to synchronize the databases, and I could solve this problem by waiting a bit, but I don't want to do more video editing than I absolutely have to. And therefore, I'm just going to delete the file that locks the database here. Which is something you shouldn't do. Please wait. And don't delete slash var slash lib slash pacman slash db lck. And now let's use this handy buttons and try that again. And now it's synchronizing the package databases, which are up to date already. And now we are installing a lot of stuff. It's 334 megabytes to download. Total installed size 848 megabytes. And let's go. Now, the biggest component of that download is, of course, the Nbox image. And because this is going to take a while, I'm going to speed up the video here. Good, now the upgrade and installing Nbox went through. Now I had issues with promptly rebooting earlier, so I'm going to see if all these changes have been written to disk yet, because I'm using a rather slow SD card here. But I used another one earlier, and that one also had a ton of errors, so it looks like all has been written. Let me just try to create a swap file right now, because that's something that's really handy when using Nbox, is to have some way of a swap. And because of course a partition would be better, generally speaking, but I I don't want to show you the process of using GnomeDisk to do that, because I would have to use a totally different, more complicated setup, and therefore I'm just going to show you how to set up a swap file, which is actually not that complicated procedure, and we will then enable that after rebooting here. Now we will use a block size of 1 megabyte and make that swap file I don't know. How about we make it 3 gigabytes big, and of course we want a progress bar, status equals progress, which is really a dumb command. Think about it, but yeah. Now it's creating that file full of zeros, writing it to disk. Then I will have to chmod it, use make swap, and then after rebooting I will use swap on to enable it. By the way, if this is going too quick for you, I doubt it is, because I'm pretty slow, but you can read up on that in the Arch Wiki. Just go to the article on swap. So you can, if you're using DuckDuckGo, you can just use exclamation mark or bang Arch Wiki and space swap, and then you hit enter and you're going to land on that page. But again, another way, maybe a better way to do this is to actually use GnomeDisks or another partitioning tool you're comfortable with, and set up a swap partition that way. And then you can add it to /etc/fstab to have it enabled permanently, but that's something I'm not going to show you in this video, because that would really go too far, I think. And I've got a battery that's not fully charged. I mean, that's another reason to be quick here. So now it created that file, and now let me just chmod 600 it. That should be quicker, I hope. Swap file, and then I will have to apply the swap file system type, which is done with mkswap and or swap, I don't know, is it even swap, I'm not sure. And yep, it did that, and now let's reboot and it's coming back on again. Yoo-hoo! Last time I tried this it didn't, and then afterwards because maybe it was because I did the partitioning right after writing the image to disk, and well, when I connected the SD card again to my computer, it only showed one partition, and that was the swap partition. So apparently my root file system had been permanently damaged. So yeah, be careful how to do that. Now I will, of course, because otherwise that swap thing would have been a total waste of time, just enable that swap file, typing sudo swap on slash swap file, which is also stupidly easy. I'll have to give it the unchanged default password here. And now let's briefly check whether that really worked with free. And yes, there is a swap and it's 3 gigabytes big. So we shouldn't run out of RAM with Nbox here. Now, as you can see, right now there's only the Nbox icon that will change after starting it for the first time. And the few apps that come with Arch Linux ARM. And I like that there are so few apps that come with it. I don't think that, you know, there's a certain benefit to it when there are more apps. But honestly, as long as it's not too few and it's this set of, well, useful stuff like calculator, camera, clocks, document viewer, Firefox, so there's a browser, flashlight, well, yeah, if you need that, Geary, Lollipop, which is a music player, maps, and so on. I think that's a good basic install, and then you can go ahead and mess it up yourself afterwards by installing tons of more packages and eventually maybe making things slow that way. Yeah, but that's not necessarily what's going to happen. But you really have to be careful with stuff that's always on the background, like using too many chat apps and so on. That can really tax the CPU and the RAM, and well, make your battery life worse. Now that looks like it failed, but that's always what happens. And then, as you can see here, it worked. So yeah, that's all these apps that come pre-installed with Nbox, and they are down here now too. So let me just quickly disable a few of them that I think are utterly unnecessary by going to the settings app and then to apps. So we have 12 apps installed, but do we really need a second calculator? I personally don't think so. The same goes for the Android camera app, which I think isn't working anyway. So we can disable that one too. Oh, I didn't disable it. Just for stopped it. That was stupid. Yeah. And then the email app, well, that might be worth it for you, but I think I will rather use Geary or some webmail stuff. Now then, the gallery app and the music app, I don't think I really need them either. So yeah, that's that. And now there is no back button, which is why we need to close this. And now that's way fewer apps. Now let's go to the Android store and add some. As you can see, the network connection is working here. That's a huge improvement that has been done for Arch Linux ARM. When I did a video about Nbox and Mobian earlier, I could get a working network connection, but I always had to go to some terminal and type in some rather long IP commands, which was something that I felt like, oh god, I can only do that over SSH, because typing them on that squeakboard keyboard is going to kill me. And yeah, so that was really inconvenient. And also there was no working keyboard, and we're going to install a working keyboard now. What still is kind of bad about Nbox is that it doesn't know the height it should use. It just uses the full display, and that therefore these bottom bars of apps are usually obstructed by that Nbox bar, and that can be of course quite annoying, leading to stuff like that you just hit the wrong item. But now let's go to the category view and go down to writing. There we are, and view all those 178 applications. So nobody say that F-Droid has no apps, right? Actually, I really like F-Droid. Back when I still was using Android most of the time, I really liked it, because these F-Droid applications are applications you can trust. and they are usually lightweight, they won't muck up your system and so on. So pretty cool stuff. Okay, now a simple keyboard should be installed, but we are facing a hang here. Let's see. Yeah, that's the settings app. And let's just go to advanced. I hope it works now. Because yeah, it can be, maybe it's swapping now and that makes everything slow. That might have just happened. Yeah, after it's all black, I can't really close that settings app window, can I? And this one isn't really showing anything either. Let me try if I can start a terminal app and see how the RAM situation is here. Because I would really like to reset the size of this. But apparently I'm having no luck here, so let me just try to reboot the system again. Or maybe it might speed up again, so okay, now it crashed. Let's try to restart Nbox, and I'm also trying to get a power cable here because it looks like my PinePhone battery is going to die otherwise. Sorry for that noise. And yeah. I don't have a power supply here handy, so I will have to try this using my laptop. It seems to charge, which is great. Now let's just briefly see how much free RAM there is. Well, yeah, some swap space also used, but that's to be expected because the kernel does that. But I think I'm just going to quickly restart here once again and see whether it works afterwards. Option to properly solve this problem would be to restart the Android container manager, which you can do with typing sudo systemctl restart nbox-container-manager. And if you want to, you can add a dot service after that, but who wants to type all that stuff? I mean, honestly, don't we all want to type as little as possible? Not because these keyboards are terrible, but just because, well, there are so much other things in life that are just more fun. So yeah, let's see whether it comes up now. Again, starting Nbox for the first time takes a while, but once it's running, it's actually pretty fast usually. And yep, that happened before to me, that it just decided to kill some stuff. And well, if you are one of the lucky people who already have their PostMarketOS Convergence Edition, you will likely have a better experience with this because you're just having 1 GB more of RAM, and that will reduce memory pressure by quite a lot. So I'm not having it yet because I'm in the EU, and I will hopefully get it, I don't know, in the next 10 days or something. I'm super jealous of everybody who already has theirs. Now that looks like it crashed, but I'm sure we will see F-Droid shortly. And the simple keyboard too. So yeah, let's see. Advanced, and here keyboard height is important because otherwise we won't be able to type space properly because it will be obscured by that fosh bottom bar there. And let's, okay, and then what else do I usually set? Well, I turn all that crap off because I don't like that. And now it says that it doesn't find recent apps, the F-Droid store, and also everything is really slow. Yeah, I don't know, maybe it's this new kernel, because before I had really better results here. Of course, using one of my slow, I will just test this thing briefly, SD cards here, which I got for €3 a piece. So yeah, they can't be that good, can they? Oh god. Yeah, I think all I can do right now is wait a little, because UI is totally unresponsive. I really dislike this. Now, when this happens to you with FDroid, that it says it doesn't find apps, you can go into that settings app, to the Android settings app, and then go to the app menu again and delete app data and cache. And once you've done that, it should be fine. So let's try to start Nbox once again. I think once it goes to swap with this slow SD card, it just all comes to a crawl. Yeah. Now let's just see whether it works. Well, but let me, in the meantime, well, I shouldn't do that now. I'm just wondering whether I should start desktop Firefox at the same time, which also consumes a ton of RAM, but I will just do that now anyway. Because, well, we've got 3 GB of swap. Hey, that should be working, right? Yeah, that's the customized version of Firefox here. And now some of you will want to use Nbox specifically for one app, and that is WhatsApp. And WhatsApp can be downloaded from the WhatsApp.com website. It's WhatsApp.com/Android. And once Nbox is running again, I will then be able to ADB install that APK file. And yeah, so it's downloading it. That's 37 megabytes. Goes down, well, at a decent speed, I think. And we're done with that download. By the way, desktop Firefox here on Arch Linux ARM works pretty well. And reminder, this is running a pretty slow SD card, so yeah. It may be even better if you've got a good one. Well, I'm likely not going to be able to start Nbox again without another reboot. Because I really don't want to type that long systemctl command for then finding out that it failed on me. And reboots are quick enough, aren't they? Here we go again. Let's slide up to unlock. And yeah. As you can see, the apps I disabled are not shown anymore right now. So eventually Nbox catches up with what you said there. There's another way to hide apps, which is just by going... Oh. Yeah, my swap partition, of course, is no more active right now. Let's just go through the bash history to save some typing by hitting the up arrow. Here we go. Now the swap should be active again. Let's check. Free. Yes, it works. And yeah, let's try. Why not try the calendar app? I mean, come on. I just need Nbox to be running so that I can then ADB install WhatsApp. So that's actually a pretty simple process. Just go to the downloads folder and then run. Once Nbox is loaded, you'll run ADB install. and then it's capital W here. Let's just tap complete that. So that would be the command we are going to run. And yeah, that's the calendar, which actually might be something you want to use, because you can install like DevDroid and then sync it to your Nextcloud or something and have at least a calendar that has a somewhat okay mobile UI, because that's something that's still lacking generally. GNOME calendar hasn't been libhandified yet, as I would call it. And now let's install WhatsApp. So it's starting up the ADB daemon. Oh, and push install is not working because it says the device is offline. Well, let's try that again. Now it apparently sees the device. Is it working? I don't know. Success. We like successes, don't we? Now, of course, it doesn't show up here yet. So let's just try that unbox launcher again and see if that comes up now. Eventually, not sure about that. But then eventually it will show up. Also, another app that you might want to use is, so that I'm not totally wasting your time, so I will download that one before rebooting again. Starting Firefox, hopefully. Yeah, okay, that worked. And that is Signal. I don't know the exact URL here, so let's just use Google, because it's, for whatever reason, the default search engine here. I have Signal APK download, and I hope Google will give us a good result here. Now, there are other ways to run Signal. There's you could use that web client and use an Android phone or iOS phone to connect to that phone and so on. Then there is Signal CLI, which is a CLI client. There is an app for UbiPorts called Axolotl, which you can supposedly run on other distributions too. You just need to compile it, and then you will have to use a browser to connect to the web UI of that one, which sounds like it's totally fun, but I'm going to do that later anyway. And here you can download that APK directly on the website, and later of course verify whether it's the true file, which I'm honestly I could do that because we're having time, don't we? Signal again is, while it's open source, a centralized service. So some people might object to that, even though it's not as fundamentally evil as Facebook is considered to be. So yeah. Did Firefox already download it? Yeah, it did. And by the way, this mobile Firefox implementation, which was done by the PostmarketWise guys, is pretty good. So let's just briefly do that. Shazam check, which now is of course useless because I didn't leave that Firefox tab open, and I won't open it again. But yeah, just see. So that's the string you would have to compare. And now let's ADB install it. And then let's go for yet another restart, because restarting is fun. Great. Performing streamed install. And soon it will say success. Woohoo! Yep. So, I can try it once more. without restarting here. But oh yeah, there it is. And now you can see Signal, WhatsApp have been installed properly. And of course they don't show up here yet, but they will probably after another restart or something, or maybe after locking the screen. I test that. And so my iPhone ran out of storage and therefore stopped recording, but I was in the Signal app and I just used this time to restart my PinePhone, and now you can see that Signal and WhatsApp are in the launcher here, and I can just launch Signal briefly. Although I just before I noticed that the phone, my phone I'm recording this with, ran out of storage. I had tried to log in with the Signal and failed because the keyboard would fail me and always enter every number I typed twice, and also the same for the delete key, so I couldn't really sign on there. Let me just turn on the swap here again. There we are. Here Signal is running, and yeah, apparently that's another issue with Nvenc sometimes. I think it's related to the terminal and Squeakboard actually. It starts up like that, and that is really annoying because then you miss a couple of elements and all you can do is close the app and try to start it again. Now that looks better, and yeah, you can just see. Okay, that's looking great. Now I can enter my number, but I won't show you that one. And see if it works now that I can sign up with Signal here. By the way, this is an interesting warning. It shows that I'm missing Google Play services, which I do. And this will essentially mean that you will have to start Signal to see new messages. You may not get notified of those. This can be mitigated by adding a micro G to the image, but that hasn't been done yet. It's doable. There is an explanation on how to do that on the PinePhone forums, but yeah, I haven't done it yet. Let me hit I understand here. Okay. So now I'm receiving a code, and let's see if I can enter it this time. No. No dice, I'm just going to show you what the issue is here. Oh, now it's working or what? Yeah, see, it only worked once. And now, if I had a code that was like this, it would work, but doesn't, of course. And yeah, so apparently signing up with Signal is difficult, and we would rather have to use, I don't know, maybe build that Axolotl stuff and use a web view. Now, this is WhatsApp, and I signed up to it before I noticed that the recording had stopped. Yes, sorry for that. And there's some stuff that works. I have set up one contact here. Yes, so yeah, that's myself. And maybe I can get the keyboard to work, I don't know. Yes, it works. So I can just write something, but it will appear on the phone that I'm recording this with, though I can't reply. But as you can see by that second error, and maybe you heard that message, it generally works. What doesn't work is voice messages. Playback works, sort of. It's a little bit choppy, you know, the visuals run through, but the sound only plays later and so on. But here, recording voice messages, of course, we need to allow this first. Hello, this is just a test message. Usually it just crashes the phone, and I don't know if I can get it to work once more. Yeah, so WhatsApp, yeah, see, it crashed. Eventually it crashes when you try voice messaging. Now let's try F-Droid once again, because it shows still this one message. And there's a way to fix that. I think it happens because Nvox crashes and fdraw then doesn't save the state properly. So what you have to do is go here to storage and then clear data and cache, and afterwards starting fdraw again, it will update its repositories and you will able to install some apps. One more thing one could actually use would be a browser. I'm looking into trying Bromite, but I haven't done that yet. If it works, I will certainly tweet about that, but I won't include this in this video because this video is already too long. So remember, WhatsApp sort of works with Nvox. Signal signup apparently doesn't, but there's another way to run Signal on the Pine phone, which can be explored without using Nvox, so that may be better anyway. And in general, I think, well, there's still quite a lot of work to be done, but it's great that there's been some progress, and so you can use those apps you will need because you have friends or family that want you to use them. I know nobody should use WhatsApp. Even Signal is problematic because of their approach of app distribution and so on, but some people of us prefer having friends and family over living a true free software lifestyle. So yeah, that's that, and I think that's fine. So have a great week. I hope this video was sort of helpful. As you can see, afterward now has the data and it's fine again. If there are any other apps you're interested in, that but it should be ones that really don't work on mobile Linux otherwise, because you know I could install NewPipe now, but you can just watch YouTube in the browser and that is a better experience. I tried that. So yeah, if you have further suggestions for app to try, please write that in the comments. Oh yeah, one more thing. There is an issue with Arch Linux ARM that will eventually hit you on an upgrade, and that is that it will, once glib is updated, it will build all the locales. So you would have to install an editor of your choice, or maybe try to use the graphical one. I'm not sure whether that works, but let's just try that briefly. And edit /etc/locale.gen. Okay, that doesn't work this way, so I will just briefly install them. Ta-da, this should be a fast install. Ta-da, we'll be done very soon with this. Yes, now we are. And now let's just these buttons are very small. Let's just go in here and it will build all these locals and you won't need most of them. Now there's a you can comment them out, which would be a procedure like this. Enter insert mode and then type this character, but that will take you ages if you do it this way. So I would recommend just let's escape that insert mode and just go delete a bunch, you know, just delete 40 lines at once by typing d40d, and let's delete another, I don't know, someone's. Now I will watch for my German here. 7, okay, now. I'm not the best person at counting in the world. And now let's delete another 10 maybe. Yeah, and then K. keep the US around 2, right? Because that's what I'm currently using. Oh, now if you did that mistakenly, you can just hit U and undo, yeah, sure. And now I will just type D100D and it's, and again, and suddenly this file is getting a lot shorter. Oh, still so many, my god. Yeah, and now there are just 2 lines left and you can save the file. And once that upgrade hits, that has to rebuild all your locales. It won't take so long. That's that. Now, finally, goodbye, have a great time, and thanks for watching.